Sophie Scholl was born in May of 1921. She would grow to become a symbol of resistance against the Nazi regime in Germany. She and her brother were members of the White Rose. The White Rose was one of the most respected resistance groups of all time. Sophie's father was mayor of their hometown. Sophie, along with her five siblings, was brought up in a Lutheran household. And by the time she reached her teens, Adolf Hitler was running the country. The Nazis invented a youth arm designed to recruit more soldiers for the Reich. Millions of children joined the Hitler Youth, including Sophie and her brother Hans. With time, however, Sophie and Hans grew disillusioned as they observed the maltreatment of Jews, culminating in Germany's invasion of Poland. Sophie wrote bitterly to her boyfriend, who was also a soldier.
I can't understand how some people continuously risk other people's lives. I will never understand it, and I think it's terrible. Don't tell me it's for the fatherland.
Sophie followed her brother Hans to Munich University, and they socialized with the same group of friends. They formed the White Rose group with other students and one professor. They printed and distributed leaflets, encouraged citizens to resist the Nazi regime, denounced the murder of Jewish people, and demanded an end to the war. At the beginning of 1943, the White Rose group would produce their sixth and final pamphlet, and it said,
"The German name is forever damaged if the German youth don't finally rise up, avenge and atone at the same time, crush their tormentors and find a new spiritual Europe."
A caretaker at the university saw Sophie distributing pamphlets and betrayed her to the Gestapo. They arrested both Sophie and her brother and interrogated them. Sophie and Hans refused to give up the names of the other members of the White Rose movement, and after a trial that was mainly for show, they were found guilty of treason and sentenced to death by guillotine. No testimony had been allowed at the sham trial, but Sophie Scholl did manage to utter the now famous words,
"How can we expect righteousness to prevail, when there is hardly anyone willing to give himself up individually to a righteous cause? Such a fine sunny day, and I have to go. But what does my death matter, if through us, thousands of people are awakened and stirred to action?"
And so at only 21 years of age, Sophie was the first of the resistors to be executed by guillotine. She remained brave, determined, and upright to the last. Her executioner later said that he had never seen a person die so bravely. Many schools, streets, and squares in Germany and Austria have been named after Sophie and her brother. They showed the world that it is possible to stand up and resist a diabolical regime like the Nazis.